nine, eight, seven. We have a go for main engine start. 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff.
Wait, I love me. I know you guys have to be feeling this song. I was really hoping that made you move a little bit. Welcome back to the show. Welcome back to SFL Nights with AJ Stryker. Thank you so much for joining me today or tonight or whatever you decide to hit that play button or turn on that radio dial. Really appreciate it, y'all. And man, I'm telling you what a little bit of rest will do for you. Man, now don't get me wrong. I missed you guys. I missed doing the show last week, but you got to know when to hold them and you got to know when to fold them. And sometimes you just got to know when to take your rest. And I decided to use that opportunity to do so. So I hope y'all understand. And I am coming to bring you a really good show tonight. I hope that y'all enjoy it. I have a special segment that I'm actually adding for the show this evening. I have a good friend of mine that lost someone very dear to him. And I wanted him to come on the show and be able to share that with us and share some other information that I feel like everyone should know and hopefully be able to help with in the future. But I will also be doing my, of course, past, present, and future reviews. I have to catch you guys up on my Who You Got. I'm not doing too bad, you know, so, you know, I think I got it pegged a little bit. I'll tell you about that in a minute. Then I'm going to be hitting you with the weird food combos and weird laws. And these are strange. And I'm going to ask my guests for my Fourth and Gold community call-in which one of these delicious items they will be trying if we ever get a chance to, especially during like our conventions. Oh my gosh, I would love to see the looks on their faces. And then I spoke of my Fourth and Gold community call-in, and tonight's guest will be Mickey Melello. It's funny because we're actually the Arizona Scorpions and the Minnesota Legends are actually bumping heads tonight. So it's going to be interesting having him on the show, kind of maybe like do a little bit of banter to start the game off, you know, on the right way. And then I will also have Mr. Derek Majors on over from Portland. He wanted to come on the week before last. Things kind of got in the way, but you know, now he's available. So happy for that. And I'll bring up my guest, Justin Reside, very soon. Thank you, Justin, for being here. I see you in the back already. So thank you, dear. Just a quick note now. I know last show I alluded to having my ladies' night show as well as an interview with an affiliate as well as possible sponsor for the Scorpions, hopefully, Lucy Red, which is an energy drink maker. The owner for Lucy Red is going to be on the show. I wanted to kind of coordinate ladies night with her being on the show. So ladies night will actually be on August the 13th. So ladies of the league, please come represent your team. Love to see you out here. You can either have your cam on or you can have a nice picture up there. Whatever you want. We just want to hear from you. All right. Good deal. So let's go ahead and get on with the show because I want to go ahead and get my guests up here. All right. So starting off with my Was I Right review. Now, I did not go over, of course, week 10 and week 11 with you guys. So
For week 10, I actually had 8 right and 3 wrong. And for week 11, I had 10 right and 1 wrong. I mean, like I said, I think I'm getting better at this, you know? And I'm gonna go over week 11 with you right now as soon as I get my graphic up. Hold on 1 second. All right. So, and I actually have it pegged so y'all can see exactly what I chose in yellow, how many I had right in green, and what I had wrong in pink. So, Denver Night Wings battled the Florida Storm, where Florida won 19-0. Excuse me. Arizona Scorpions battled the Portland Fleet and won 33-27. Canton took on Motor City. Of course, Canton won 51-30. Oh my gosh, Canton. Baltimore Vultures battled the Atlanta Swarm and Baltimore won 35-16. Fort Worth Toros took on Indianapolis Ramblers, where Fort Worth won 24-14. Alamo City took on Tulsa and Tulsa won 27-10. Vancouver Legion battled the DC Dragons, where DC came out victorious 38-3. Carolina Skyhawks took on the Louisiana Revolution, where Skyhawks won 31-20. LA Lycans battled San Diego Mavericks, where San Diego won 41-24. Jacksonville took on Seattle, and Seattle won 6-0. And finally, to end things off with that way, the Queen City Corsairs battled the Charleston Predators, where Charleston won 27-12. So now, as you know, the way the show works, I do my past and present and future review. So right now we are in present week 12. And last night we did have 4 games that took place. I do hope that you got a chance to watch them. Some of them were blowouts, that's what it was. It was just a blowout. And other ones were really interesting to watch. So if you do get a chance to go check out these games on your own, of course, you know, content creators, we're going to give you our viewpoints and everything, kind of quick synopsis. But nothing beats going to watch these games yourself. Go to simulationfl.net to get direct links to these games, the game playbacks. So week 12, I did make my picks for week 12 as well, as you can see, again, in green and in red. I am at 3 right and 1 wrong already, which means I am grand total 79 right and 41 wrong on the season. Pretty impressive, if I can say so myself. So Friday night lineup included San Diego taking on Canton Classics. Oh, man. And Canton is firing on all cylinders. I mean, Florida is going to have a handful with them next week. But talking about this week, 47-3 victory. San Diego scored 3 points in the fourth quarter only, with 173 yards passing, 48 yards rushing, 221 yards total. They held the ball for 19 minutes and 2 seconds, but they had 5 crucial turnovers. Canton scored in every quarter, scoring 7 points in the first quarter, 13 in the second, 14 in the third, 13 in the fourth quarters, with, strangely enough, only 35 passing yards, right? But 244 yards rushing for 279 yards total. 20 minutes, 58 seconds, clean game, no mistakes. I am asking this question. I have to stop right here. Canton, how was that all Logan Lee? Because I forgot to look that up, but it sounds like that might have been all Logan Lee. How? We up here struggling. Please tell us how. But good job, man. Good job. All right, so back to the games. Motor City took on Carolina, and it was a battle of the North versus the East, where the East won. Carolina 34-20. Good game to watch, too. Carolina scored 3 points in the first, 14 in the second, 14 in the third, and 3 points in the fourth quarter. They also had 212 yards passing, 138 yards rushing for 350 yards total. Motor City, no points in the first quarter, but 13 in the second. No points in the third, but 7 in the fourth quarter. 178 yards passing, 122 yards rushing, 300 yards total. So Motor City definitely was working on having a balanced game, but Carolina just came out firing on all cylinders and completing most of their passes. Great game. DC Dragons took on the Tulsa Desperados, also another great game to watch. And DC wins 34-21 over Tulsa. DC scores 7 points in the first quarter, 6 in the second, 14 in the third, 7 in the fourth quarters. 231 yards passing, 181 yards rushing for 412 yards of offense. Wow, DC. Tulsa had had their points in the second half with 14 in the third quarter and 7 points in the fourth quarter. 224 yards passing, 56 yards rushing, 280 yards. So DC found a key to stopping Gabriel Manning, it seems. And I think that that was one of the keys for DC winning this game. Good job. LA Lycans, the one I got wrong, took on the Portland Fleet. LA wins 24-17. You know, it's funny because I thought they were, may have won this game, but I went with Portland. Gotta go with LA. LA scored 24 points and was only stopped once in the whole game. LA scored 7 points in the first quarter, 10 in the second, and 7 in the third quarters, whereas Portland had 10 points in the first quarter and 7 in the second, but nothing else all game long. Portland also had 239 yards passing with 96 yards rushing, 335 yards total. Time of possession was 20 minutes and 8 seconds, where LA had 159 yards passing, 181 yards rushing for 340 yards total. Time of possession, 19 minutes, 52 seconds. So it looks like these coaches are actually finding their footing on how to get the run game and the pass game more involved. Perhaps it's understanding how the game works a little bit better now. Perhaps it's the team build, you know, the books that are being chosen. It's matching the team bills, you know, a lot better now to be able to get you to have that more effective outcome. But, hey, I'm liking what I see in there. It's very competitive, you know. Most games were. You do have those, you know, those other ones that, you know, clearly were blowouts. But, hey, everybody goes to them, you know what I'm saying? We even had some. The Arizona Scorpions had some. We had two games where we scored no points. So it happens. Just got to bounce back, you know. All right, go ahead on with my present picks for tonight. Guys, we do have games tonight, so please head on over to Simulation Football League's YouTube page. Go ahead and set your notifications to watch these games. One of them, of course, our game, Arizona Scorpions, taking on the Minnesota Legends. Oh, it's going to be a really good game to watch. I am actually starting to be involved, and I'm trying to learn how to run sims and things like that. So when I tell you that Minnesota is freaking hard to prepare for, they really are. But still going to give us the win tonight, but this will not be easy. And it's going to get ugly. So it's going to be a good one. So I really hope that you guys come out at 6:30 p.m. Eastern to check out this game. Also a good game to watch. That's actually going to be a battle in the Central Division too. Denver Nightwings will be taking on Mexico City. Also a good game to watch. I'm going to go with Mexico City Aztecs. It's going to be a home game for them. And Denver honestly has been struggling. So I'm not sure which, offense is going to be coming out there tonight. So I think Mexico is going to be ready either way though. So we'll see. Louisiana Revolution will be taking on the Fort Worth Toros, and I do have Fort Worth winning this game at 9 o'clock tonight, battling the South Division. It's going to be a good game, but Fort Worth has been firing on all cylinders like they typically do. They actually fly under the radar a lot. People seemingly don't talk about them. I don't know why, but they are a great team too. Another great team to watch is the Florida Storm taking on the Jacksonville Kings at 9:15 p.m. Eastern tonight. Jacksonville struggling right now. Florida undefeated. Got to go with Florida on this one. They're the sure thing. No football on Sunday as it is Easter Sunday. So we will start things back up with Monday night spectacular games that include the Atlanta Swarm taking on the Houston Headhunters, where I am going to go with Houston only because it's a home game and Houston seems to do incredibly well at home. So I'm going to see if we're right about that. Quickly, I'm going to go over, and I got a comment in the chat. I'll get to you in 1 second. I do see that future picks, because I'm not going to do the entire thing. Even though I do have that graphic just in case, you know, people want to see, oh my gosh, is she picking them on the day of? I'm like, no, my stuff is pre-picked. All of my stuff is pre-picked. So you can see it, take a screenshot, whatever you want to do. But my picks for week 13, this is going to be a good game. San Diego taking on the Tulsa Desperados and the Charleston Predators taking on the Atlanta Swarm. Both games will be happening Friday, April the 5th. At 8 o'clock and 8:15 p.m. Eastern, again, on Simulation Football League's YouTube page. And I do have both Tulsa and Atlanta winning these games, home games. San Diego has been struggling as well as Charleston. Charleston actually has not really been struggling that much. It's just that sometimes, again, I don't know which Charleston team is actually going to come out to play, you know. So with that uncertainty, you know, I'm going to go with the Atlanta Swarm. And it is a home game for Atlanta. Atlanta does incredibly well in the Hive. So remember, if you don't like what I say, just prove it on the field. I don't mind being wrong. I mean, apparently I was wrong like 41 times already. So like, it is what it is. It's just all fun and games. While I bring up my guest, I, Justin Reside, I'm going to go ahead and go to the comment section and see in the chat. Let's see here. Jay Ballmer, greetings and salutations to you. Thank you so much for joining me today. Really appreciate it, man. All right, so Justin, welcome to the show. This is Justin Reside, everyone. He is overcome from Queen City Corsairs, and he came to me this evening. Yesterday?
Tuesday.
And with some very sad news, but he wanted to share this with everyone.
Yeah.
He wanted me to be the platform that he shared it on. So,
yeah. So, unfortunately, on Tuesday, it was actually official, it was on Sunday. It was Tuesday when I got the notice that my good friend, close friend from Special Olympics, KCJ Mears, she unfortunately passed away due to her injuries that she suffered in an accident on February the 29th of this a month ago now. Yeah, there she is, the one with the glasses.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you know, when you told me that, you know, I called you because I remember having a conversation with you. Maybe it was just a week prior, or maybe a couple weeks prior, and you told me she was in hospital. And I told you,
yeah, Capitol Health. She was in. She was at the time breathing. At that time, she was breathing on her own at Capitol Health. Capitol Health Trauma Center in Trenton at the time.
Well, man, anytime you deal with loss, you know, it's difficult. And yeah, what I told him, you know, at that point, and what I'm going to share with everybody here, you know, is that I've lost my father, you know, and even though he was going through a lot of issues health-wise, I knew that that was going to be a scar, but that scar heals eventually so it doesn't hurt as much. But it's gonna be there. But every day it's gonna hurt just a little bit less. But what I can tell you is that this community is a wonderful community, Justin. And they're definitely gonna be here for you in your time of need, because I know it's hard for you, especially anytime you lose anybody that's close to you like that. And I know you guys have been friends for a very long time. Yeah. Share some stories. What are some good stories that you wanna share about?
Yeah, she, you know, when she and my friend Natasha shared the apartment, I always went over there. Like, we celebrated like my birthdays and New Year's Eve. Had a New Year's Eve party all the time over there. There were such great times, and also we did a lot of art dances. And you should have seen her on the dance floor when I think it was John or was another DJ played a Pitbull's Fireball. She was doing her Zumba dance, man. Holy crap, that was. Oh, man. And especially every, you know, it's like every single summer games, like this one right here, this was her, obviously her last ever summer games doing bocce. She always, I just can't believe she's not going to be in that Lions Stadium, in the Lions Stadium walking with Otter County this year.
Well, physically, no. But here, she will be. You know what I mean? And it's going to take some time. But we're your family, and we're here for you, you know? And I know that you have a link that she wanted to share. What is that link about? I did put it in the description.
If you go to sonj.org, if you go directly to sonj.org, which is, of course, the obituary asked for this, by the way, her obituary asked for this, to donate her name to Special Olympics Jersey, which is sonj.org. You click the little, link is in the description. But if you go to that website directly and you click on donate now, it'll send you that same link where you can donate to Special Olympics in Casey's name, because that's what they're, in the obituary, or it's in the, instead of flowers, you make a donation to them in her name.
All right. And before I let you go, is there anything else that you wanted everybody to know about the Special Olympics specifically? Yes. Well, I'm going to actually put this link up in the, I'm going to put this link up in the,
on the YouTube, in the YouTube, or in the YouTube chat or whatever.
So this is streaming on multiple platforms. So what I'm going to do is put this link that you gave me. I'm going to just put it in the chat real quick so people can go directly to it while we're live. And then anybody watching the playback, they can just get it from the description. Yeah. And this is it. But is there anything else that you wanted people to know about in regards to the Special Olympics? And
yeah, this, it's always, I always compete in all the sports. Softball's coming up soon. So it's, it's a big deal for me to participate this year. And especially, with the passing of Casey, it's going to be definitely a somewhat of a harder season, but, she's always going to be there with me. And, I have Natasha and them to talk to as well.
You have Natasha, have the whole Queen City locker room, you have me, you have other members of the community, so we're here for you, okay? Well, thank you, Justin, and, call me if you need me. You have my number. Yeah. Call me. I'm going to go ahead and move on to my next segment. You can stick around if you want to be on for my community call-in if you want to hang out.
Yeah. Yeah, sure. I'll do it. I'll definitely do that. Because Mickey because I love talking to Mickey about his emergency calls of the week. I can't wait to hear what he's got.
Oh my God! When he wore that Sasquatch.
I remember that set. I've seen those pictures, man. Holy crap!
It was so hot in that hotel, and he comes in with this Sasquatch costume. And I think he had like a little water thing in there so he won't pass out. It's 1,000 degrees. But I'm going to bring you back on a little bit later, man. Just stick around, everybody. Yeah. I'm going to switch over to Weird Food Combinations and Weird Laws by State. And these are doozies. And again, Justin, and I don't understand why people make these decisions. To do these things, and then we have to make laws for them not to do it. And you wouldn't understand what I mean in a second.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, Trent has a weird law. Trent has a weird law about pickles, so on Sundays.
All right. See you soon.
Yep, see ya.
All right, everybody. I'm going to hit you with the tunes while I prepare for the next segment, okay? Oh, my gosh. Y'all should have saw him in that Sasquatch outfit. Oh my, if I had a picture, I promise you, I will show you, but enjoy this next set, this next Hold song.
Yo, hold up. I woke up, got out my bed, it was a sunny day. Brushed my teeth, clean my skin, cause I love my face. Ain't got time for all that stressing. I'm receiving all my blessings, about to love and hug myself, cause I got time today. Whatever happened yesterday, guess what, ain't worried about it. On my masterpiece today, you know I'm about it. I ain't stressing about no bills, I ain't got no time to chill. Put some problems in my face, I'm just gonna bounce about it. Like, why you mad at me? Because I chose to love myself, yes, I am proud of me. Not where I'm trying to go just yet, but I'm about to be. Now put your hands up in the sky and be thankful you still here and stop asking them why. Lord, I got it, you know I got it. Look, buddy, I got it. And ain't nobody on this earth gonna ever come and stop it. Cause I'm from the country south, got something to say. Spun a big boy with 3K, and they let me bounce out of my shoulder popping. Bounce your shoulder, feel the vibe. I ain't stressing today, yo. I ain't stressing today. Bounce. You negative, well, I ain't got time. I ain't stressing today, yo. I ain't stressing today. Bounce. Peace and love is on my mind. I ain't stressing today. Yeah. I ain't stressing today. Bounce. I'ma tell you one more time. I ain't stressing today. Yeah. I ain't stressing today. Bounce. Watch my whip today. I bump it up good with the shammy. Feeling good. Think I might just pull up on my granny. We watch that Wheel of Fortune while we eat that turkey chicken. She tell me that she been thinking one day I'm gonna win a Grammy. I say now shout out to my barber. That boy on a mission. Got my line so crispy when I talk they pay attention. And my lady is so bad, swear she was born in her bag. Had to give her extra care to go tip her beautician. Like, how you look that good? I'm about to show you off, let's cruise up through my neighborhood. You said my partner tried to holler, boy, I wish he would. You know what, I ain't even much tripping. I'm confident in me, so can't nobody catch me slipping. And don't call me on FaceTime, I be barely texting. Try to love her for myself, I'ma send me a message. Nah, please don't hit my line if all you got to do is lie. It don't matter, I ain't gonna check, I'ma be busy flexing. Bounce your shoulder, feel the vibe. Stressing the day, yo. I ain't stressing the day. Bounce. You negative, well, I ain't got time. I ain't stressing the day, yo. I ain't stressing the day. Bounce. Peace and love is on my mind. I ain't stressing the day, yeah. I ain't stressing the day. Bounce. I'ma tell you one more time. I ain't stressing the day, yeah. I ain't stressing the day. Bounce.
Hey, hold up. Why you mad at everybody out there? Did you plug yourself today? Bounce. Yo. I ain't stressing the day. I ain't stressing today, yo. You got somebody who getting on your nerves, trying to ruin your day. Hear what you tell them, yo. I ain't stressing today. I ain't stressing today, yo. This silence.
Hey, don't stress. That man had a good point in that song. Ever since I found it, I want to say maybe a couple weeks ago, I just kind of ran across the stream, right? My YouTube stream. And I was already having one of those days, man. And oh my gosh, like that changed my whole attitude. And so I pretty much listen to that song every day. And when I don't, like, I feel like I need it. But man, it's a great song by Dear Silas, man. Y'all gotta look him up. Really good. All right, so now we are back with weird food combos and weird state laws. And today, guys, we are visiting Maine and, hold on, Utah and Maine. Now, just in case, and I do this just in case you're out there traveling, you know, sometimes you go into another state and you might do something and then all of a sudden you're getting a ticket, or you might be getting a little bit of jail time because you did something that you just didn't know that you were not supposed to do. So I am going to help you out with that. And it's funny because next week I'm going to have my daughter on the show and we had a nice discussion about breaking and entering. Can you break without entering? Can you enter without breaking? Vandalism and trespass. That was a whole discussion, man. I gotta show that with y'all. Yeah, I gotta have her on just so we can have that in front of y'all because it was nuts. But anyway, so in Utah, respect your librarians, guys. If you're trying to go check out this book, or maybe get the latest, you know, music. I don't know what, you know, people just don't really go to the library anymore, I guess, because everything is just so accessible. But if you do, respect your librarians, or they can detain you in Utah. Those sweet and friendly librarians are far from helpless when it comes to reclaiming a stolen library book. According to Utah's code 76-6806.60, any employee of the library who has probable cause to believe that a person has committed library theft may detain that person on or off the premises. So they like top flight security of the world for like books, because I'm telling you this right now, if I'm a librarian, somebody want to steal a book, guess who's not going to go out there and try to chase anybody? Won't be Ashley. We can order another one. You can't order another me. So y'all can keep that one. Don't promote milk discrimination. According to Utah's law code 76-6-105, anyone in the business of buying milk products cannot discriminate between sections, communities, localities, cities, or towns of this state. That's a big no-no in Utah, which can make you guilty of a Class B misdemeanor. So now, as I was looking this up, I guess maybe I'm still kind of having issues understanding what that really means. So anyone in the business of buying milk products cannot discriminate. So if I'm lactose intolerant, that means I have to get the regular milk. Like I can't just get the lactose free milk. Is that, if somebody in Utah can kind of explain that to me, because I'm not trying to get a Class B misdemeanor, if you know, just let me know. All right. In Maine, let it go. You will be fined if your holiday lights, people, are left up later than January the 14th. So that neighbor that has their lights up in July, understand that they are lawbreakers. Now, how did this law come available? I mean, did they just, you know what? I'm sick of these lights. I'm sick of people having Christmas all year, just stealing joy from everybody to say, hey, you know what? Nah, you ain't doing that. That's crazy. Also in Watersville, Maine, though, it is illegal to blow your nose in public. And this pretty much is a good one for y'all to know, because I don't want you going out there and you got allergies, you know, and you running and stuff. And all of a sudden, you know, you just go to the mall and you want to blow your nose and you just get rolled up on and going to jail because you broke the law. So don't do it. Also in Maine, it's also illegal to step out of an airplane once it's in flight, because I guess people usually do that. You know, they just be like, oh, this is my stop. Whee! And then they just, you know, they don't even wait for the plane to land in Maine. They just said, this is where I'm going to be. And again, somebody had to do this in order for it to be a law. So I guess no parachuting either. So people like to go skydiving. I guess you can't do it in Maine. I'm telling you, these laws, they still exist. You can look them up online. I don't know why they're there. I don't think they should be, but hey, to each his own. Now we on to the good stuff in Utah. Now I know you guys saw this delicious pie that I have on the screen for you right now. Now, for those that are wondering, yes, that is a pickle. And yes, it is a pickle pie. Rather than saltiness and acid, this pie is rich with sweetness, much like chess pie. A slightly tangy crunch from the pickle, which tastes more like pickle relish, comes through on the back end. The pie is filled with chopped sweetened pickles and flavored with cinnamon, sugar, egg, half and half, lemon zest, allspice, and don't forget the whipped cream, y'all. So, now I do know my girl Skippy over there from Carolina. She loves making desserts, things like that. Cheesecakes. Oh my gosh, she makes the greatest cheesecakes ever. I wonder if she'd be willing to make this pickle pie for us, and maybe we can have it at this year's convention and see how many people would be willing to try it. I mean, I got the recipe on deck if you want it. Next up, I know you probably saw this deliciousness too. Tamale toast, lobster tamale toast. Now, tamale, I need to let you guys know, is a delicacy. It is a lobster pancreas and liver That is the soft green substance that is found in the body cavity of the lobster. And it's served on a, like, as a spread on toast. It could be whisked into sauces or softened butter, like you see here. This is delicious toast points with lobster tamale. That's going to be a no. I had a really bad experience with liver. Went to a chicken place, you know, that sold chicken. So you can't, I feel like if I order chicken liver from you, it should be good chicken liver. No, it wasn't. It left like a really irony aftertaste in my mouth. Couldn't do it. I tried liver one more time. Went out somewhere, had some liver and onions. Man, when I tell you, it looked good. It had some rice and gravy, and it was all nice and set up. When I tell you, that iron flavor hit my palate after, I almost gagged. I couldn't do it. So liver is not my forte. I know that. I've tried it twice in my life, but I want to encourage you to try it. So when I do have my guests up here, I'm going to be asking which one they will be interested in trying today. We are going to go ahead and switch over to my fourth and goal community call in live, y'all. I'm going to hit you with the tunes real quick while I get set up for that as well. See you soon. If I can get the music.
Dime, esto es lo que tú querías. Yo soy fino, esto es trap de galería. Tú eres un charro, Rocky de aquí, una porquería. Yo un campeón, Rocky Marciano, Rocky Balboa, Rocky Balbía. Tengo la ruta, tengo la vía, sí, tengo la vía. Los gastos de noche facturo todo el día. Tanta plata que me gusta que me chapen. Por eso le meto a tetas al pío. Ustedes no saben lo que es estar en alta mar con 200 peros. Que los zafatas de mi diploma en el cielo. Lo que tira el 500,000 en dólares duple. Por eso tu opinión me importa cero. Por eso tú estás 101 en el top 100 y yo estoy primero. Ya no son raperos, ahora son pocateros. Más que tú estás cobrando mi barbero. Estoy viajando en el mundo entero, ey. Bebiendo mucha champaña, nunca estamos secos. Primero llego Verstappen, después llego Checo. Si Pablo me viera, dirá que soy un berraco. Usted hablando mierdillo, lo mío por Monaco. Bebiendo mucha champaña, nunca estamos secos. Están hablando solo, están hablando con el eco. El signo del dinero, ese es mi nuevo zodiaco. Prende un puro, la familia está en Monaco.
J'avais 20 ans, je caressais le temps. J'ai joué de la vie, comme on joue de l'amour. Et je vivais la nuit, sans compter sur mes jours qui fuyaient dans le temps.
Crème. Los carros de F1 son más rápidos en persona. Sofía Vergara es linda, pero es más linda en persona. Lo que tú hagas a mí no me impresiona. Es como meter un gol después de Messi y Maradona. A ti no te conocen ni en tu barrio. Ayer estaba con LeBron, también con DiCaprio. Me preguntaron que cómo me fue en los estadios. Hablamos de la familia y temas de millonario. Digo, multimillonario. Digo, de billonario. Hace rato sin cojones que me tiene la radio. Hace rato me quité del trap, yo se lo de al audio. Uy, depositaron a los Grammy, nominaron. Otra vez me criticaron y ninguna me importaron. Ya sigo tranquila en la mía. Don Vito, Don Vena de los Beatles. John Lennon a mis nietos. Cuando muera les va a dejar sin terreno. A todas mis doñas las pompí en el sol. Y
y a mi haters un F40 sin los frenos pa' que, pa' que se estrellen, hey, pa' que se maten. Rojo, blanco, negro, mate, cuál tú quieres, pa' que, pa' que se estrellen, pa' que se maten. Que pa' descansen, yo sigo en el yate, ey. Bebiendo mucha champaña, nunca estamos secos. Primero llego, Verstappen, después llego Checo. Si Pablo me viera, dirá que soy un berraco. Ustedes hablando mierdillo, lo mío por Monaco. Bebiendo mucha champaña, nunca estamos secos. Están hablando solo, están hablando con el eco. El signo del dinero, ese es mi nuevo zodiaco. Prende un fili, la familia está en mo.
J'avais 20 ans, je caressais le temps et jouais de la vie comme on joue de l'amour. Et je vivais la nuit sans compter sur mes jours qui fuyaient dans le temps.
All right, and we are back. We are back. Now, while I am waiting for Mickey and Derek to get logged in, I have Justin Rezaad back on with me. So Justin, yep. While we're waiting on them, we might as well go ahead and ask, get this question out the way.
Oh, geez.
Which one?
I knew it was coming in the first place.
See, if they would have been here, we could have just, you know, kind of whole sidestepped the whole thing. But no, we're gonna go ahead and go first. So, are we doing the pickle pie? Or are we doing a tamale toast?
Pickle pie, definitely. Because, oh, don't show that pickle. Oh, my God. I don't want to see the lobster.
Hey, that's a delicacy, hey, man.
I know, but I don't. Oh, God.
That's a delicacy. You know what I'm saying? Uh-oh. We got Mickey here. Mickey Malello. Hi.
Where am I? Is this space?
Yes.
Okay.
I changed it up. You know, I want you to feel, you know, otherworldly when you're here. You know, just like you're in a whole different space.
Okay. I just wanted to make sure because I all of a sudden I'm like, okay, here, click this link. And next thing you know, I'm near Uranus. I don't know how that happened.
I can't. That is not how you pronounce that. It's Uranus. First off,
no, that's the new pronunciation. The original pronunciation until everybody started making fun of the planet was Uranus. Now everybody's Uranus. And I'm like, that still doesn't sound too right. I mean,
either way, just change it up altogether. Okay. Hey, man. Welcome. Welcome to the show, even though we are going to be facing each other tonight.
You're right. Why do you think I put the hat on? Just because I knew it.
The flag right there.
Yeah, I see your flag, but I also see the Desperados flag there.
Well, that's my OT.
I know, but I see more of the Desperados than I see the Scorpions. What's going
on? No, because that's just the way the camera's angled. Don't do that. Hey, man, welcome back. It's been a minute since I had you on the show. How you been?
I'm doing good, with the exception of working a late night shift last night and totally missing your message. I'm just happy you got here.
Me too. Justin was, you know, busting at the seams, happy that she was going to be on the show. So it would have broke his heart. Mine too, if you wouldn't have made it. Just tell him.
Well, I am happy that I decided to just roll over at the right time and see your message and just come on. Don't worry. To everybody who is watching, I do have pants on.
I don't think that was on the minds of the viewers, but you never know. You know, I have radio listeners too. They, you know.
To the radio listeners who can't see me, that I'm not just a floating head in space. I have pants on, don't you?
I can't. Yeah.
Yes, you can. You invited me on the show. This is gonna happen.
Yeah, I did. It's been a long time. If I would remember.
And hey, last time I was, you know, doing things with Mickey, it was with he was announcing a game, I think. What was that week? What week was that, Mickey? Was it?
It was you in Alamo City. So I think it was about 4 weeks ago, 4 or 5 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Introducing Derek Majors, everybody, over from the Portland Fleet, coming to join us today. What's going on, man?
Yo, what's good? How everybody doing?
Doing good, man.
Yeah.
Doing all right. Enjoying your Saturday.
Well, Saturday's going good, and it's going to be even better in about 4 hours when Minnesota puts another one in the win column.
Oh man, good luck with that. Thank you, God. Y'all looking good.
Thank God Queen City has the bye week, because I don't have to worry about a freaking freaking loss on our record, dude. Five. I think it's five, right? Five.
Yeah. I'm not worried about Mickey. You know what I'm saying? You know, I fully expect for him to root for his team, even though we all know what the outcome is going to be at the end of the day. It's all right. I'm going to let one dream. All right.
Yeah, but, 31-10, Minnesota.
No, okay. All right. We're going to see. Trust me. Yeah. Even though, I ain't going front, I'm learning how to do, like, run sims. And you did, hey, preparing for Minnesota is no joke. It really isn't. Preparing for a few of these teams are no joke, but Minnesota is definitely one of them. So it's going to be a good game tonight.
Oh, it is. You know, I love you, Ash. I just got to rip you. I told you the only time that we are enemies is going to be today.
That's it. It's the end of the day.
Like me and Derek Majors are going to be enemies next week.
I mean, yeah. I mean, we played, you know, I played Ashley earlier, like a few weeks ago, and, you know, it's the same thing, but it's all love once we, you know, once we get off the field. So it's all good.
Hey, man, I'm telling you, that was a pins and needles game, bro. Like, that was not. I'm throwing picks. Y'all just have a natural knack to want to be drawn to the balls I throw. I don't know what the hell is.
I mean, it's just our defense in general. Our defense is just, you know, we play like that ever since, you know, we started. So, I mean, that's the whole reason why I love this team. You know, I think, you know, no matter what the turnover was, you know, the defense always stayed the same and we always stayed with the same philosophy. And that's why we're so good. But, you know. That's why I like it. That's why I love being in Portland. You know, unfortunately, all good things got to come to an end soon. So, but other than that, that's all. Yeah. It's all good things, though. It's all good things.
Indeed. You know, I'm actually going to touch on that a little bit later. But I wanted to know what are your thoughts on your seasons from each of you? Because Justin being over from Queen City, Mickey being over from Minnesota, and of course. Derek being over from Portland, everybody's on different spectrums. So I'm curious to know, what are your thought process right now that we're coming to the end of the season? And unfortunately, you know, the ending of an era for, you know, one of our teams here. I think I'm going to start with you first, Justin, on this.
Yeah, I think Queen City is just, we've been talking about it all season long. It's like, we need that one number one wide receiver. Adrian Ellis is a good wide receiver one, but it's just we really need a wide receiver run over here out in Buffalo. I can't, even though I live in Jersey, I just have to say in Buffalo because I'm not being fun. It's like real life 5 hours away from Buffalo. It's like, I'm not used to saying that.
I will say that you guys have definitely turned it around. Queen City is definitely a different team from the past. I've been here since season 12, you know. So when I've seen you guys, it was kind of like that up and down kind of struggle. And then for a while it was leveled out, kind of like bottomed out kind of thing. And now you guys have seemed to, maybe it was the game switch, maybe it was just a fresh set of eyes, you know, with Chad Stinton and Alex over there. It works. And it is working. So I would definitely, you know, give yourselves a pat on the back for even just turning around that season, the trend that was going on, you know. Gotta give you credit for that. Yeah. Mickey.
Yes.
What are your thoughts?
Our season. So I mean, we started the season 0-1. If you remember way back when we lost our first game, it was kind of a rough start to a season that then became really great. This is our best season, one of our best seasons so far. We have a chance to, you know, clinch the this week. We have a chance to clinch the Central Division with a win. No, that's not a dig at you, Ash. That's just pure statistics there. It's the first time that Minnesota, and granted, Minnesota's won the Central last year, even with a 4-8 record. So again, even just turning around and reversing the record possibly and being able to clinch the division with just a few weeks left is something that we have not done yet. So it's just another great thing for this very young franchise to be able to do and win the division three times in a row, I believe, making the playoffs all 4 years of their existence. I mean, this has just been an outstanding season. For me personally, I am ranking their top four kickers right now. So personally, I'm hoping for an all-star, but I don't know if that's going to happen.
Hey, you never know. You never know.
You're right. You never know. But I haven't had a chance to actually be in consideration, and this is probably my first time. So we need to score a few touchdowns today. I need to kick a few field goals, and I'll be right back in the running to be the number one.
Well, I'll tell you what, you can do that next week, bro. But what we're not gonna do is let you be breaking records on our watch. You know what I'm saying? You can definitely do that next week. But
I didn't say anything about records. We're not gonna treat you like Indianapolis last season, and we're not gonna nice you and put up 69 against you. Okay.
You better hope you win.
I said I'm
going to be in your DMs as soon as that game over with.
I said I didn't want that to happen, and I'm genuine right now.
Glad Queen City has this week off. Glad.
That was actually more of a dig at Indianapolis than it was at Arizona.
Okay.
Sorry. Make me cry.
Derek. Derek, what are your thoughts on Portland, man?
Oh man. I mean, I guess the best thing to say is a roller coaster. You know, like every season. I don't know. I think, you know, after I reflect on everything, because I just wish things just went better, if that makes sense. Like, you know, of course, like it feels like everything that we wanted always came too late. You know, at the beginning of the season, it's like we always started to figure out, like, you know, first, second, third game, we were still kind of figure things out. You know, one thing, you know, if the offense was working, the defense wasn't. But if the defense was working, the offense wasn't working, then about like the fourth or fifth week, things get to come together. But we're already 4 or 5 games behind, you know. And then, I mean, we saw that this season. You know, we was 0-4 and lost 4 games straight, 5 games straight. Then we went on a 2-game win streak and then, you know, lost the last few. And I don't know. I just think it just – the league just wasn't nice to us, man. Like, it's just that simple. Like, we just – things just didn't work out the way that we wanted it to. And you can see what the front office wanted to do and how they wanted to – you know, bring guys in that was about the culture and just, you know, wanted to win. But in my opinion, it just things didn't, like, we just didn't have those guys to get us over the top. You know what I mean? Like, it's, and it's no disrespect to any of the guys that came through and the guys that we have. You know, we got some ballers and we got guys that can make plays. But it just, when you see the different teams that, you know, that wins championships and that win games, you know, they have those guys that can get over that, you know, that can get their team over the hump they need to. And I don't know if it has to do with the salary or anything like that, but it's just to the point we just needed some guys, and no matter what, we always pulled through. You know, we never made excuses no matter how the games ended. I mean, last night, the way that the game ended was tragedy. And that was just the epitome of what Portland was. You know, it's always, you know, we have these crazy games where it's like a shootout, and, you know, this is what Portland can be if they're on their, you know, if they at 100% every game, but things just falter, and it just, you know, we always get the back end of the things, and it's nobody's fault. You know, it just, you know, we just have to play better, you know, regardless of who we're playing against. You know, we got to be better, and, you know, we just need to have those guys that was there. But unfortunately, we just won't be able to, you know, see what happens if we bring more guys in that wants to win and that's want to be a part of this culture. And that was the whole reason why I stayed every single season since I've been here. You know, I believed what Jacob and Mel and all these guys, you know, everybody wanted to, you know, bring to Portland. And unfortunately, I wish I could have, you know, done more, but, you know, I did as much as I could. But, you know, it's nothing bad, though. You know, everybody that came in and out of there, and even the front office, you know, it's all love with them, and they only want to see the best for every single person. And Jacob is one of the, I always tell him, you know, he's the literally one of the best owners, even though that's the only owner I played for. He's the best owner that I will ever play for. And, you know, it's all love with him, man. He makes sure that every single one of those guys in that locker room is taken care of, whatever it is, make sure they're on their P's and Q's, and make sure that, you know, we're all in the right spot. But, you know, it's a hard league. It's a tough league to play against. So, you know, things just happen for a reason. And, you know, unfortunately, you got to come to an end. But me personally, I'm excited for the next chapter, and, you know, just seeing wherever that goes, you know. But, you know, like I'm always going to say, it's all love, though. It's all love. It's all love with Portland. You know, they're always going to be a place, you know, they got a deep, deep place in my heart. So, you know, but it's all, you know, and that's what this season, I feel like that's what this season came down to, if I'm being honest. Even before Jacob came with the news about, you know, Portland not being no more by the end of the season, I had to do some self-reflection myself. You know, even though I tell my fiance all the time, I have to tell her, you know, I got to think about what's going on next, because, you know, I want to win. You know, I want to win a championship. That's what we all plan for, to win a championship. So that's got to be the next phase, and got to be the next, you know, something I want to, a goal that I want to have checked off. And, you know, even if it wasn't going to be with Portland this year, you know, regardless of what happened, you know, I would always have to think about it and actually think about, you know, if this is going to be the place that I'm going to have to be at next season, or, you know, going forward. So, you know, I think it's happened at the right time. You know, I'm proud of Jacob, regardless of, you know, how he felt about it. But, you know, I'm proud of everything that he did, and, you know, what he brought, you know, brought to this league. And, you know, I was proud to be a part of this team. So, and I even told him, as long as I'm here, as long as y'all don't want me here. You know, I will always tell him that, I'm here as long as you don't want me here. So, you know, I think it's just, it's a good thing to, you know, just go out, you know, once it all, you know, everything that's happened, you know, it's a good way to end it. So.
Well, I definitely, whenever you have a team that folds, you know, or plans to fold like that, you look at the players and the tenure of the players, the people that stayed through all of those tumultuous times where you weren't winning. Yeah, you celebrate the good things and the bad, but you guys were there from day one. So when someone is looking to add someone to their roster from a team that folds, I think that should be one of the qualities that they look at, is how long were they on that team? How long did they subject themselves to whatever that team went through?
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, that Portland front office should be, and I'm sure they are, absolutely ecstatic for those that stayed and tried to work it out and then tried to be that they needed to be able to go over the top, you know?
I mean, I don't, and again, I don't want to take up too much time with this either, but even if you look at the guys that we have, you know, we still got Cyrus Drive, we got, you know, Scott Johnson, even though, you know, this is second year still, you know, Zeke still back there, you know, running the ball, you know, Mel, you know, Chris Thatch, all these guys that been here since day one, you know, they see what they were trying to bring, you know, they see what we were trying to do and what kind of culture we were trying to build, you know, and that's why I just say it sucks, because, you know, you can see it, like, even if during the Sims and, you know, during the off seasons when everybody just got there, you know, it's we're all in the same page. Everybody's on the same page. And it just, it really sucks when it just doesn't come together, man. And it doesn't, and it sucks even when it doesn't come together, you know, after the second game, after the third game, after the fourth game, you know, things like that. And then once you see what we can do by the third, you know, by the 10th or the 11th game, you know, towards the end of the season, it's like, oh, man, you know, then you got to wait through a whole nother season to get this started. And then things just keep going the same thing, you know, keep doing the same thing. And it's, you know, and it sucks. It definitely sucks. But we're just competitive. All the guys that stayed through all that, we're just competitive, man. And we just believe every single, you know, every single season that we can get this done. And even, you know, we put other teams on notice. Even they saw it, you know, Portland's going to be hot. You know, we're going to do this and that. And I think just this thing, we just have to build off that, you know, instead of just, you know, resting on, okay, let's see what we can fix here and there. But we just need to build on that, you know. And but unfortunately, you know, that just couldn't get done. So, but I just speaking on everybody else, though, you know, any guy, you know, any team that takes any of the guys from this locker room, they're going to get ballers, man. They're going to get guys that are committed and just going to want to win. So no matter who they end up choosing or who they want to go and get, all these guys are, you know, they're worth it. So it don't even matter.
Which is kind of the point I was making. You know, so I'm glad you caught on to that. We're going to move on because I have a question. I actually got a couple more before we end things. Mickey was, he worried about missing, you know, that loss they're going to take tonight. He really worried about missing the hail. So, you know.
wait, hold on. Now I got to change my name. Because of that, I was going to be nice to you. Now I'm going to change it. Hang on.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
There we go. That's
better. Oh! Oh. Instead of getting Black Queen City's on
he was ready for that.
He changed his name to his title to Scorpion Stomper. And what he gonna come back with is one of those stingers stuck in his foot that he ain't gonna be able to play next game. And then he gonna be like, oh my gosh, my career is ended because he tried to stump a scorpion and he didn't know what he was doing. But to that point, two top teams that are undefeated. Well, right now, Florida is undefeated. They do have a game against Jacksonville tonight. Barring they win this game, Canton and Florida will be undefeated. Guys, they meet up next week. Who do you have on this game? And why? Now, before y'all start, Canton turned it around, just like a lot of teams trying to find their footing, came in not winning, you know, and they just did a complete 360 this year, and they haven't lost any games. Florida has won this title before. Florida has been undefeated before. Florida has many championships. So it is interesting to see how this championship and current championship winner, you know, crown holder versus this fiery team that is the Canton Classics that are just coming in red hot. So who do y'all have on this game? It's very difficult to call. And I'll start with you first, Mickey.
For me, there's no doubt about it. If I had to choose, it's going to be Canton. Canton has been truly dominant in every game, practically every game that they have played. Look at the score yesterday. You know, they. I was trying to pull up the broadcast research sheet just to see their points for the season coming into this week. I couldn't pull it up quick enough. I was kind of hoping you'd choose Justin first so I could throw some stats out to you. But I'm sure. No. You picked on me. I'm not going to pass the buck. I, you know what? I can do two
you
don't, things.
Yeah, you're not. Are you trying to throw the stat guys under the bus?
I'm trying to give the stat guys credit for all the hard work they do. But you know, if I look, I guarantee, and I'm pulling it up right now. I'm sure that they are number one in points for the season.
Listen. In week 11, what was it? They scored like 51 points? What was it?
Yeah, 51 points.
51-3.
And Yeah, 51-3 last week or 2 weeks ago. They are number one in point. I'm sorry, Ash. Go ahead. Okay, so looking at the research sheet, they're number one in points for with 312 points. They are number one with points against, 41 points against. 41 points against before this week is a little more than four points given up a game. So
yeah,
that's just a dominant team right there. And if I'm going to have to choose anybody who's going to win next week, I'm going to have to choose Canton just based on statistics alone. And I give my guy up here partial credit too, because it's his stats team that gives us those stats that I can look back at.
Love it.
We're like the Brady Bunch right now, you know. So
this is a weird Brady Bunch.
This is the new Brady Bunch. You wanted me on here. You knew what you were getting into when you asked me on this show.
I need to select my guests better. Justin, who you think? Who you got? Canton or Florida?
Canton. If they can shellac Queen City, can they shellac anybody in the SFL?
Woo. Okay. Derek, based on what you've heard, who you?
Okay. So, I'm sorry. Florida, they're undefeated, right?
Yes.
They're undefeated.
Well, yeah, they got a game tonight.
But they're undefeated, though, right?
Yes.
And I remember a few weeks ago, Portland, we played them. And all I remember was, what's his name, Charlie Belitsky, the running back, running up and down that field all night long. All right. If he gets going, no. It's over with. Like, there's not even no discussion. Like, I've been watching them since last season, since they won that championship, and they just been going and going and going and getting better. No matter what, they get it done. No matter how, they get it done. I don't think it's going to stop tonight. So, give me Florida.
Ooh.
I got to go with Florida, too. Now, reason I say that is because I think that having been there before, being in this position before, having that experience of being a winner, whether you went through an undefeated season or whether you're the current winner now, anybody can lose. I understand that. Canton is a beast. Logan Jack just had 244 some yards by himself, like something like that. At least it was close. And I'm like, If Logan goes off, you cannot stop him. They're going to run away with the game. They have figured this game out. Florida seems to be the only team that could put them away because of the caliber team that they have, the players that they have. Canton will have to be, if they weren't on their A game before, they're going to have to be with Mighty and Art over there. I think I'm going to go with Florida on this one for the sheer experience.
Is Florida going to be home as well? Are they going to be home?
Hold on, let me see. I think I have it pulled up. 1 second. All right, so this is week 13 right here. So, yes, Florida will be at home, and this game will be on Sunday, April the 7th at 6:30 p.m. This really, in my opinion, should have been the Monday night game. I think everybody should have been tuned in or would have been tuned in for this one, you know.
Hold on, because I know who has the Monday night game next week.
Who?
Minnesota and Indianapolis. You're not.
Oh. Let me see. Minnesota and Indy or Florida.
Ash. You were at the convention last year. You know how big that rivalry is. It doesn't matter if both teams are winless. It's still going to be a good game, and the trash talking is going to be all over there. But I will agree with you with the situation that's going on right here. If Cam had to flex that game, I could see him flexing that into the Monday night game.
You wouldn't be mad, right?
I wouldn't. Not okay, for you. If it was something for like Arizona and Tulsa, I might be a little upset about it. But come on.
That would be expensive. You know what? That's a great game to watch. Don't hate. You just hate it. Anyway, but yeah, it's good that these coaches are finally figuring it out. Even like LA, great win for LA, you know. Unexpected. I know. Overall, I know that there was a questionable. I think there was a questionable call in that one.
Kind of weird, right? But you know, hey, we're used to it. We're used to those.
Well, I'm really hoping that you and the people from the teammates that will remain from Portland will definitely find a place where y'all can go ahead and contain your careers, man. Because you know, you got a good thing. You know, it's just being utilized correctly and finding the way to utilize everybody is very difficult. And that's something I also wanted, before I move on to my next question for you guys, that's something that I also want to let everybody know that's listening, that if these coaches have the anxiety and the stress levels are so high because they have to try to take care of the 27 some odd members on their team, make them happy, try to get them involved. They want to get their stats up. They want to hear the name on the field. They want to hear this. And then you got to make sure you're hitting those deadlines for your books to be submitted. You got to figure out which book works with your team. And it's a lot that goes into coaching. It's not easy. And then switching from what you were used to from seasons, years that you've been dealing with one game, then switching over to another one with whole new rules. You're dealing with money now. It's just, it's different. So for everyone that continues to remain patient, you know, with the time that the league is doing with the transitions, you know, I think it'll work out in the end. You know, but you do have to remain patient. You do have to remain diligent, and you do have to roll with the punches. So some of this stuff is not easy, you know, to really stomach at first. Zero, when I see, you know, my guy DJ Moses, he was balling out one season, and now zero stamina, and I'm like, oh no, DJ, what's wrong? What happened? You know, but it is for us. If Canton can figure out how to get it done, if Florida can figure out how to make Charlie Bielecki run all over everybody, I know we can too. So it's just about putting in that work and then having our teams and having everybody else that is not on the teams that are going through this to understand, like, yeah, you can have your jokes, you know, your back and forth. But at the end of the day, these are real feelings. These are real people that are trying to do something to help other people, you know, further their careers. And if you're offering the correct constructive criticism, that's awesome. But if you're just plain being rude and downright disrespectful, you know, calling people trash, right, and you don't even know what they're going through, I don't feel like you have the right to do that. So that's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. So who do you think will end up in the championship game? I know I went past the playoffs. I didn't went past the playoffs. Will be, and I'm gonna let you name four teams that you think could make it to the championship game.
I'm gonna go. I think I'm a okay. Just my four, the four off the top of my head. I'm gonna go Minnesota one.
Okay.
That's literally like they've been balling out all season. So I'm going to go Florida number two. One of the teams that I think they're a dark horse. I just think they could turn some heads, like, because just seeing how they play in just Seattle, they can be a dark horse. That's just my dark horse right there.
Okay.
I'm gonna have to say Canton as well.
Okay.
Those gotta be my top four right there.
Gotcha. Mickey?
Obviously, I'm gonna say Minnesota.
Obviously.
I definitely have to Canton in there and Florida. The fourth one is probably a team that everybody doesn't want to hear, but has expects it every year. I'm going to say Baltimore.
That was going to be my next one, but I just, I don't know. I just think Seattle would turn some heads, like, if they make it to the playoffs. If they close out and make it to the playoffs, I think they're going to turn a lot of heads.
You know what? I agree with you, Derek, 100%. And I love Doug Day over there at the Seattle franchise. But my big thing is that we played Baltimore a couple of weeks ago. And they're on a three-game winning streak right now. So they were 3-4 before this win streak. And they somehow turned it around towards the end of the season. And they're starting to win games. So I could see Baltimore being the Baltimore team. And Ash, we talked about this in PGI a couple of weeks ago. And being Baltimore, they game planned against us.
Yeah.
And they game planned very, very well.
When they get hot, they stay hot.
Down in the Arizona desert in 120 degree heat in the middle of July. That's how hot they get. So they are my number four team, and I say it with all the love and all the of Baltimore being the franchise and the dynasty that they are, but they're like the New England Patriots of the SFL. They're in it every year. People want to see somebody different, but I have to give credit where credit is due. I do believe they could be the fourth team other than the top three teams that have remained stagnant throughout this whole year so far.
Okay. Justin?
Yeah, I'm going to say Florida, Canton, Fort Worth, and Minnesota, because they're the top four right now in the wildcard race.
Yeah. You know, I was wondering, why do people not mention Fort Worth Toros? Why don't they come to the forefront of your mind when you are making these selections? I feel like they go under the radar a lot.
I mean, don't underestimate Hacker and
But I feel like they still don't get, I don't know, to me, maybe it's just me. I just feel like when you're listening to different people, like people don't really mention them. They don't really, explain what they've been doing and the good seasons that they typically have. They kind of just coast, I'm just wondering if you had a thought or opinion about why that could be. Especially being a broadcaster position,
And I actually did. I think that my first game that I did this year, if I recall, was the San Diego Fort Worth game. And it was a very exciting game. I believe it was the final was 28-21, if I pull up a score. Fort Worth. Bear with me. Sure. No, maybe it wasn't that game that I called, but either way, I think I called the Toros game this year. I'm almost positive I did. And I think the Toros is just one of those underrated teams. They have a Steven Hacker. They have, they have names of the league, but I just don't think, for lack of better terms, they haven't had that excitement. And
I was
the player that balled out for a game. You always hear, with Canton, their running backs are just running all over the field. Each one of their running backs, everybody in their backfield ran for more than 80 yards last night. Florida, same thing, just throwing all over the place. With Minnesota, you hear about our defense. You hear about Johnny Reno tossing the ball down the field. You hear about our receivers, Colin Hart, a Hall of Fame candidate. All of them, you hear about these players. I think with Toros, it's just that underrated team that just is flying under the radar. Yes, they are four in the standings right now. They've got that first round bye, but there just hasn't been the excitement. I'm looking back at some of their games. Their closest game so far was to Minnesota, where they Mexico City, where they won 38-31. Mm-hmm. Last week, Artillery and Fort Worth. That was the am I looking at this right? No, I am not looking at this right. Again, I just woke up. Bear with me.
No, stay sleepy. Stay sleepy. I'll do the game and everything.
Yeah. But I think that's it. They just haven't had an exciting game. And it was the Fort Worth San Diego game where San Diego just wound up crushing Fort Worth 34-7, the one that I broadcast. And there was just San Diego did everything right in Fort Worth. Just couldn't get the ball moving. And with that, when you look at how they've done this season, two games won, one game loss, one, two, three games, four games, then a loss, then two games won. Like they can't get a good streak going. Where when you look at Minnesota, you look at Canton, you look at Florida, obviously for Canton and Florida, they're on a winning streak period for the season. Minnesota lost the first game, seven games in a row, lost versus Baltimore. They have been the talk of the league since essentially week four, just on how they were doing. Whereas, you okay, Justin?
Yeah, it's just my phone going off.
Okay. Let's say, is that a fire alarm? you talk like that. They have been the talk. The top three teams have been the talk of the league. They have shown excitement. They have had the multiple big games and blowouts and exciting games and things like that. And Toros are just flying under the radar. And yeah, I think that's why we don't talk about them too much.
Yeah, I just think it's to the point where it's like, you know, even at the games that I did catch with Fort Worth, it's always, you know, like he said, even if it wasn't the excitement, it's more so like one-dimensional. You know what I mean? So yeah. It's so like, you know, even if they did, you know, when they do make the playoffs and once they get there, it's going to be sort of easy to game plan again. So you're not looking, and it kind of sucks to sit there and try to write off a team before it even starts. But like at the same time, you kind of could tell like, okay, well, we know where they're going to go. And, you know, we kind of could figure out what they're going to do. So it's not much to be, you know, there's not much to be said about it unless they do come out, of course, and blows everybody's minds with this whole different type of game plan that, you know, nobody expects, but that's what we kind of expect from Fort Worth. And that's the last time, you know, every single time I see them play, it's kind of the same thing. So that's just where my head goes when it's, you know, and it's not even about the respect. I mean, they're winning games, you know, they're doing their thing still, but it's just all the point of, you know, can you get your team over that hump? And do they have those guys to do it? I don't think just, you know, Stephen Hacker is going to be the lone guy to get it done.
Interesting. So before I get ready to close, I want to know what we eating tonight, y'all. So we are going to, I'm hoping to see you guys at the convention, you know, hopefully be able to make it out there in Texas. But what I'm really hoping is that we can bring some of these delicacies from the show that I've introduced this season. And maybe we can have some people actually try it, you know, on site, such as pickle pie, y'all.
Wow. No.
Can I finish?
No, please put it. God, no, take it away.
Hold on. So it's a pie that's filled with chopped sweetened pickles, flavored with cinnamon, sugar, eggs, half and half, butter, lemon zest, allspice, and don't forget the whipped cream, y'all. I mean, no. You can have that. No? Okay. Well, how about this? Innocent looking little toast, you know, a little tamale toast over from Maine. And it is the tamale from the lobster that they actually make into a delicious spread. And they serve it on 2 points. Yes. So what y'all doing? We doing some lobster tamales or we doing some pickle pie? What y'all want?
I guess I'm just naive. That's where we going.
That's not an option. That is not an option. I am trying to pickle pie.
We're trying to feed you, okay? We don't want you on the street.
Okay, if I had to choose, it would have to be the bread because I can't do pickles at all. Like, no.
Oh.
It would be the bread. I mean, because the bread, it was just like, you know, it's whatever.
Oh, sweetheart. You don't know what's on the bread, do you? Let me enlighten you. Hold on 1 second. So, tamale consists of lobster pancreas as well as its liver. And it is the green substance found in the body cavity of the lobster itself. And this is what is used to spread on the toast. Sometimes they mix it in sauces or with or with softened butter. But what she just said, she was going to try it.
No, I'm good.
So, I just want you to know what she was going to be eating.
Nah, I'm straight. I ain't hear all that.
God, I think it can hear it.
You know, it's crazy because,
It's
crazy because when it showed the lobster and it showed the green stuff, I wasn't even paying attention to the green stuff that was on the lobster. I just thought the bread and stuff. So I'm just thinking it's like something that, I didn't even pay attention to any of that. I just thought it was like just lobster on the bread. Like, nah.
I thought that was avocado.
I mean, maybe you can imagine that it's avocado when you try it. Mickey, is that what you're trying at the convention? Is that what we're doing?
Oh, hell no. You know, as much as I said no to the pickle pie, I'm going to have the pickle pie. I am not eating no lobster pancreas, lobster liver with excrement from their intestines put over ciabatta, okay?
Listen, well, Mickey, but they put butter in it.
It don't matter! That is a part of the lobster you're not supposed to eat, and not the excrement. No excrement, please. At least I know where a pickle comes from. It's a cucumber that's drowned with a bunch of salt, spices, and it tastes good. I don't know about with cinnamon and sugar, but, you know, that looks good. Now, here's the thing. Take off the whipped cream. I think that sweet and savory right there might not be good. But, Jesus, excrement. I don't want lobster poop.
Mickey, the pickles are sweet, dear. So it's not like you're biting into a dill pickle that has sugar. No, it's not. It's not like that.
Oh, but, in that case, definitely the pickle pie.
Pickle pie it is.
Pickle pie. I expect that to be hand-delivered to me by you saying,
oh, Jesus.
Oh, grateful kicker, here is your prize after a win tonight.
Oh, you got me messed up, bro. I don't know.
Again, glad Queen City has the bye week.
Wait. If we lose tonight, you want me to serve you pickle pie, bro?
Yeah, sounds good.
I'll tell you what. I'll serve you pickle pie as long as you have that Sasquatch outfit you had on.
You think I'm not going to bring it?
I mean, you almost died in the last time. You almost died.
Oh, no, it's okay, because I just spent $150 on a brand new ice vest to make sure I don't die this year.
I'm mad you're dedicated. You're going to buy a whole ice vest. You know we're going to be in Texas. You know how?
Oh, I know.
You're going to...
Ash, I talked to Cam about it. Where they're showing the games is right next to the pool. So I'm going to have my Sasquatch outfit on. Once Minnesota wins, whomever they're going to play, I'm going to strip down to my shorts and t-shirt. When I say shorts, I mean shorts, not underwear. And I'm going to jump into the pool. Look. I may be short. I may be short. I may have the only muscle may be my foot in this league, but I'm not dumb. I know I've got a plan. Oh, Derek, you just missed everything.
I'm so sorry. My phone was just, my camera was just acting up and stuff, so I had to restart it. But I'm so sorry about that, y'all.
All right.
All I can hear is y'all just laughing in the background. I'm just like, oh, I'm missing it.
And just to say this, if by chance I'm not with Minnesota and I'm with the Corsairs, I will dress like a pirate. If I'm with Arizona, I will dress like a scorpion.
And oh, I got to see that.
And for you, Derek, and I'm going to say this only because I have much love for Jacob, your owner Jacob, from when I met him in Vegas. And him and I went back and forth with the Stone Cold Steve Austin video that I made after the Adams won the championship. If I was on Portland, I'd dress like a ship. Okay? I would be a battleship. All right? The only thing that I don't think I could dress like is a broken down car if I ever became a Rambler.
Don't let Chad hear that. Oh, shit.
I'm wondering what that would look like. You know, I'm wondering.
Oh, my God. I
can't. Okay.
I think Chad's going to be in his DMs in about 2 minutes.
Ash, I'm banned from the show, aren't I?
Screenshot it.
I figured you're going to DM from Chad in 2 minutes, Mickey.
Screenshot it.
Oh, wait, there it is.
You know what? What I should do is have team rivalries in the league. I should do a show just with teams.
Cool.
That just have teams. So of course, Indy and Minnesota is going to be there. But any other teams that just feel like they have this rivalry that, you know, I love you, but I really don't like you. I really
friendly
don't.
Space. Well, that's all it is. Just a friendly space, just so they can, you know.
Yeah.
And let me put this out there. I got a chance. So Chad and I have broadcast many games together, and we have fun in the booth together. I met Adam Wiseman and a bunch of the other Ramblers in Cincinnati last year, and they are great guys and everything like that. We had a few, you know, we spent some time at the bar together, BSing, spent some time in the lobby. But once the 2 hours came for our game, and the other person I got to talk about is Tyler Falk. You know, him and
I got to work with that guy in, what, an hour?
Tyler and I mean, we were great friends from some of his minor league broadcasts and things like that. So I have all the respect in the world for them and everything they do with their organization. But when it comes to the rivalry, I have to rib them. And I just have to say what I say. But I do have all the respect in the world for every one of the individuals.
That's what's so fun about it, though, right? It's like when y'all have their respect, and y'all can just, you know that it's just a game. It's just a game. So,
Absolutely.
It's all love at the end of the day. You know what I mean? Because you can joke. You can rib. You can really throw out some zingers there, you know. But as long as you can come back at the end of the day and be like, you know what? I still love you, man. You're still my brother. You're still my sister. It's just not when we're playing each other. Oh, we got Skinny. What's going on, Skinny? Always good seeing you, man. All right. So last thing, exercise before I let y'all go. I have been doing this new thing on the show where I'm trying to lead, even though we may come from different spaces, different places and all of that. I want all of us to be on the same page once we leave this show. So, if you're good at math, awesome, which I have statisticians here and stuff like that. So, you know, college graduates and all. So y'all good at math. What I need y'all to do is either get a sheet of paper or just memorize this in your head. I would like you guys to pick any number that you want, as long as you can add and subtract by this number easily. I don't care what number you pick. Just pick it in your mind or put it on a piece of paper. I would prefer you have a sheet of paper because I'm going to tell you to draw symbols next to it to kind of keep things easy, especially for my radio guests. So once you have selected your number, I want you to put a circle around the number, okay? Okay, everybody got their number? Let me know when you're ready.
Okay.
All right. I'm good.
Cool. Now, I want you to add 5 to that number. Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Got it.
Okay. Now, I want you to add 2 to that number.
Okay.
Okay. Now, I want you to add 4 to that number.
Okay.
Okay. I want you to put a square by that last number that you just wrote down. So the number that you put the circle by, I want you, so put the number that's in the square, and I want you to subtract the circle, the number that you have circled. And then that should give you a number that I want you to put a heart around. So basically it's square minus circle equals heart. That's what you should have. And let me know when y'all have that number inside of the heart.
I got it.
Okay.
Yeah, I think I got it.
I'm waiting on you. You got it?
Yeah.
Okay. People at home, I hope y'all ready. People listening to the radio, the number that is inside that heart that everybody should have on their paper, on their phone, or whatever, should be the number 11.
Oh, my God.
Oh. 18, you got to be... Oh, damn it.
You are right, but the only heart that I have should be number 23, Colin Hart.
Oh, you...
Yeah. You always got to be extra. Look, did you... 11, so we're all on the same page.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Hold on. Yeah. In my head. My head.
That's crazy. How you do that?
It's just about bringing the human connection and helping all of us be on one page. That's how I did that.
That's amazing. I'm shocked.
Well,
I thought I was doing it wrong the whole time, to be honest. I'm just like, wait a minute, what's it say?
That's what I'm trying to use. I'm trying to use the symbols and everything because, you know, it's when you're trying to subtract numbers and, oh, shoot, what was that? So that's why. Awesome, man. Well, I want to thank y'all for taking time out with me. I know we got to get ready to go. We're an hour and 41 minutes into the show. This has been a great show. Oh, I'm really excited. Excited to be back. As y'all know, I had to take a little break last week because I was tired. I didn't want to make up any excuses, be like, oh, I had something to do. No, Ashley just was tired. That's all it was. So I'm back. I want to thank y'all so much. Oh, my D&D dice. I want to y'all to give your final words. You can do shout outs, you can do quotes, you can do any poems, you can sing a song. But right now, I'm going to give everybody their individual time to say what's on their mind, and then I'm going to end the show. So I'm going to start off with Justin Rezaad first.
Yeah. To every, you know, shout out to everybody in SFL, Casey Mears, love you, my bestie. You're always in spirit with me, just like my dad says about Matt. You know, always choose happy, and that's how I feel today. And I always have to choose happy.
And remember, we're here for you, Justin. Okay?
Yeah.
All right, Derek.
Well, not much to say, but everybody enjoy the rest of y'all night. Gonna go out with my fiance. Today is my 31st birthday, actually. So
hey!
Gonna have a good time tonight.
Enjoy.
Get a nice juicy steak, you know. So but you know, other than that. Everybody, be safe. Have a nice night. Good luck to Minnesota. Good luck, Arizona. I got Minnesota tonight. So just, I'm sorry, Ashley.
Get out. Get out.
I'm sorry. I just had to put that out there. I got Minnesota tonight. So.
Yeah, get out of here, man.
Don't worry, I'll be talking about it later, too.
It's all good
for real.
Let me get up out of here, y'all, because I gotta get ready. So
all right, brother, thank you.
All right, Derek, happy birthday, man.
Yeah, happy
birthday.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
See you next week, Derek, on the field, by the way.
All right,
take care, y'all,
and you too, and Mickey.
First and foremost, Ash, thank you for bringing me onto the show. Again, my apologies for being late. I didn't get off of work until 8 a.m. Pacific time, and I set 4 alarms and slept through all 4 of them. So, so thank you and my apologies. Of course, to the Minnesota organization, BJ, Axel, Stephen Black, everybody over there, just, you know, making it such a great season so far. everybody in the SFL community, I mean, you guys have just been great to the point that, you know, every year I look forward to this convention and just seeing everybody that I have met, who I have yet to meet, who I've conversed with. I've made some great friends in this community. So if anybody is still on the fence, if you want to go to humid Houston, as I am going to call it, do go. Because when I first went to my first convention, which was in Las Vegas, I was a rookie and I knew nobody. I've met Ashley before from her show, but I never met her face to face. But I made some great friends, including Ashley, Eddie Gage, Jacob from Portland, Mike All from Canton. I mean, I can go on and on and on about the people that I met that I had just had a great relationship with, and just, it's just a fun time. So if anybody out there that's not a part of the community yet and you're thinking about joining the community, you know, first hit the like and subscribe button for this show, then go ahead and go check out the Simulation Football League and just join, put a player in, because this is one of the best communities in the world, one of the best virtual communities in the world.
Totally agree, man. At the end of the day, it's all love. Can't wait to see what we do tonight, Mickey. It's gonna be a good game. No matter the outcome.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't, Ash. Like I told you in PGI a couple of weeks ago, we are friends. We will be lifelong friends. But today is the only time we are enemies. And I'm going to rib you just like I rib Chad and Adam from the Ramblers, just because we have that much love for each other.
Indeed. And I'm going to have that nice fork and that hot sauce when you got to eat that crow later, okay? I mean, at least I'm making
fire before you put a little hot sauce in that bad boy. You just make sure you have that fork and ice cream for the pickle pie in Houston.
Hey, you the one got to eat it, not me. So.
But you're the one that's going to have to serve it up.
Again, glad Queen State has the bye week. Glad
Justin, you're not out of this, because at some point in time, we're going to have to play you, and then all of a sudden, at the next convention, you're going to have to serve us some lobster excrement or something like that.
It's flavorful. I keep telling y'all that.
You know what? If this wasn't a family show, I'd tell you what it probably tastes like, because it's excrement. The born and bred New Yorker who has four letter words as part of his normal vocabulary really curbs it on your show, Ash. And I'm not going to say it. We're on YouTube. I don't want you to get demonetized.
Hey, I'm a born and bred New Jerseyan, so we're right, you know, we
I don't get paid for the show, no way.
Well, listen, okay. Just know that I am doing my darndest here to make sure that I keep it clean, because you are the director of community conduct, and I really don't want to get kicked out of the league.
You don't want to get high wind.
I don't want to get pulled into a private chat with Ash. Mickey, listen, let's talk about what you said on the show, okay? Yeah.
Like I said, you don't want to get high wind.
Yeah. Let's put it this way. The kicker doesn't want to get the boot, okay?
That's what I mean by high winded.
Yeah, okay? I know what you meant. I'm putting it towards my situation.
Oh, man. I love you guys. Y'all have a good night. And I'm looking forward to chatting up with you again sometime soon. Nikki, I'll see you later at the game, okay?
You got it. Be on the field.
All right, love. Bye, y'all. Right. Bye. Everybody, that is it. I really, really hope that you enjoyed the show tonight. I mean, today. It was a pleasure to bring it to you. As you know, we had this, you know, it's kind of a roller coaster, right? You know, you had your good times, you had your bad times, you got things that, you know, kind of in between. So I hope that you were entertained, and I hope that you learned a lot. Looking forward to bringing you another great podcast next week, y'all. But until then, y'all stay safe, treat each other well. If you would like to post your goodbyes in the chat, I will. And then, see you soon. See you next week. For Justin, Eric, Nikki, Riker, wow.
I got your love. You need to look no further.
Don't you know that?
Don't you know that? After my love, you'll never need another.
Don't you know that?
Don't you know that? I don't make no promises I can't keep. And I promised myself that I'd love you forever. How many times must I say that? For you to understand, yeah, don't you know that I without a doubt,
you are
my sweetest inspiration.
Don't you know that?
Don't you know that? I'm always down for anything that you say.
Don't you know that?
Don't you know that? I love you so, yeah. I really love you, don't you know, yeah. Know that I really, really do, yeah. I'm really so in love with you, yeah.
You know that,
oh, ooh, yeah. I used to doubt every girl that I'd meet. I thought that nobody could knock me off my feet. But you are the one who made my heart bell ring. And that's why I'm sure that this is loving, yeah. Don't you know that I love?
Don't you know who me?
Oh, don't you know that I love?
Don't you know, oh yeah.
Don't you know that I love?
Don't you know
you
that?
So?
Don't you know that?
Don't you know?
Don't you know
that I